The museum that exposes specimens denied by science August 13, 2019. An unconventional museum located in London has aroused the curiosity of many by challenging the species of living beings classified by science. The museum that exposes specimens denied by science dragon. Preserved remains of fairies, gnomes, dragons, werewolves and other creatures are part of this unusual collection that is displayed in London under the Maryland Cryptid Museum. The pieces that are part of the collection are the most amazing ever known, as reported on the museum's own website in 2006. A fund was created to analyze and compare a large number of wooden boxes that were found sealed in the basement of a London home prior to its demolition. The museum that exposes specimens denied by science. One werewolf's head, apparently intact since the 1940s. The boxes contain over 5,000 specimens of flora and fauna, collected, dissected and preserved by many scientists, teachers and explorers of other forgotten cultures, alternative species denied by contemporary science. On the other hand, the collection also housed many artifacts of curious origin, such as a supposed machine to stop aging. Who was Thomas Theodore Marilyn? According to information provided by the museum's own website, Professor Marilyn was born in 1782 in Hellingshire, Northern England, in a rich aristocratic family. His mother would have died during childbirth, being raised by his father, Edward, an army general. The museum that exposes specimens denied by science. Two fairies. Once retired, his father fell in love with esoteric natural history, devoting the rest of his life to traveling the world in search of illusory artifacts and hidden species that supposedly resided in forgotten continents or mysterious places, far from prying eyes. They traveled together for many years until their father suffered a sudden death. Since then, Thomas has found comfort in his work and in continuing the collection he had started with his father. In 1899 he took a small portion of his specimens to tour the United States, but was unsuccessful because of the conservative attitudes of scholars at the time. So much so that, as explained on the museum's website, many considered the exhibition pure blasphemy. Over the next few years, Marilyn expanded the collection exponentially and traveled all over the earth, attracting followers and researchers who added new pieces to their collection. The mysterious basement of the orphanage during the spring of 1942, as explained on the museum's official website, a person who identified himself as Thomas Theodore Marilyn contacted the Tunbridge Boys Orphanage. The museum that exposes specimens denied by science. 3 case, vampire. The alleged Marilyn, who was about 160 years old, but looked about 40, wanted to donate an important London house to that institution for his enjoyment. The only conditions were that the house should never be sold and that the basement should never be opened. In addition, the man who claimed to be Thomas quickly disappeared without a trace. Marilyn's property was also sold and the money donated to charity. The orphanage kept its promise of the basement until it was necessary to demolish the property to make way for a new residential neighborhood. That was how the workers found the basement by chance and, upon entering, found thousands of mysterious sealed wooden boxes. And while some specimens are clearly the product of human ingenuity, it is no less true that there are others who might intrigue even the most skeptical. The museum that exposes specimens denied by science. For gnome. Whatever the case, the unpublished collection will surely raise many questions. Forgery, artistic creation. If fairy tale protagonists and their fantastic creatures really existed, it would challenge our knowledge of nature and at the same time feed the question, why hide it? If some pieces are shown to be authentic, it would constitute a paradigm shift to the science and history they told us.